Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Amir Hussain and you are watching Trick I Know YouTube channel. This video is about Lattepanda Alpha. This is a single board Windows 10 computer. It comes with Intel 7th generation processor, which allows you to do multitasking works like 4K video playback, gaming, video editing, and any other multitasking works which you can do in a regular PC. I got this review unit from DF Robots. Do you know who they are? If you want to make a robot, go and check their website. So guys, in this video, I am going to explain what the Lattepanda is and how powerful this thing is. So without wasting any time, let's get into the video. So guys, let's begin with the unboxing. I got my parcel from DHL and here is the packing of the DF robot with nice bubbly wrapper. I have a knife to cut it off. And here is our Lattepanda Alpha, the most powerful single board computer, which is compatible with both Windows and Linux operating systems. Wow! Now let's see what's inside the box. So here is the first look of our SBC with a nice packing. Let's open it up. And here is our main board, the user manual, US based AC lead, European AC lead, black and golden Lattepanda stickers, Wi-Fi and Bluetooth antennas, and some nylon standoffs. And finally, we have a USB Type-C power adapter for Lattepanda Alpha for all countries. Now have a look of our product. You can see, guys, I am holding a Windows 10 desktop PC in my fingers. And this thing is very powerful. Trust me, guys, very powerful than the other single board computers. Now, guys, jump over to the hardware specifications. In the top of the board, we have a power switch, HDMI port, LAN port, 3.5mm audio jack, Type-C socket for power, and an optional 12-volt battery in socket. While in the bottom, we have three USB 3.0 USB ports, CMOS battery slot for BIOS, a power LED indicator, a set of GPIO pins for system, and another set for Arduino. In the center, we have a cooling fan for our CPU, GPU, and RAM, and also for eMMC storage chip. In the back side, we have M key M.2 slot for NVMe SSD storage drives. For additional LCD, we have a display and touch socket, and also a micro SD card slot. While in the other side of the back, we have a eKey M.2 slot to add extension cards on it. We have one more extension slot over there and a inbuilt card for Bluetooth and Wi-Fi facility. Now let's see some general specifications of the board. First, it supports dual OS, Windows plus Linux. It comes with the 7th generation Intel Core M3 7Y30 processor, 8GB of LPDDR3 RAM, Intel HD Graphics 615, which supports 4K video at the rate of 60Hz, Wi-Fi and Bluetooth 4.2 support, Microsoft high definition audio, and 64GB of eMMC inbuilt storage. So this is about my review unit. The new Lattepanda Alpha have 8th generation Intel processor with the speed of up to 3.4 GHz. And this Lattepanda board is faster than the following MacBook and the Lenovo laptop. Now guys, move over to the setup part. First, I am going to install those nylon standoffs. Let me take those out. First, take the small screw, insert it in the corner hole of the Lattepanda board. Then take the nylon standoff and tighten it like this. And do same with the each corner holes of the board. Here I did them all. Now it's ready to put on the table. Now here how it looks. Now I am going to install those antennas. These antennas have ability to stick on a surface if any custom case you have. The installation of the antenna is so simple. All you have to do, just put the antenna wire end to the small round socket and push it using a screwdriver or a forceps. It will rotate like this after a successful installation. Do same with the second antenna and check it by rotating it. Here is the closer look of the antenna which I have just installed. All it will look like this after those installations. Now the next thing you have to do, you have to choose your AC lead. We have two AC leads, one for the European countries and one for the US. But in India, we have option for the both. So I am going with this one. Now take out the power adapter, guys. Then open up the lead and plug it like this. Now it's ready to use. For interface, I am using a Logitech wireless keyboard and mouse. And as a display, I am using a LG 22-inch IPS display monitor. Now I am going to power up both devices with their adapters. Here the HDMI from the monitor plugs in, Type-C cable from the adapter, and also I am plugging the dongle of my mouse and keyboard. To start this device, all you have to do, just press the power button for 3 seconds and then release. Now guys, have a look on the boot time. This is the real boot time of Lattepanda Alpha, and this device have pre-installed Windows 10 Pro on it. So it took 16 seconds to start up. That's amazing and faster than any normal desktop computers. And like every normal desktop, it have its own BIOS to change hardware settings and to install other operating systems like macOS, Linux and Ubuntu. Yes guys, you can also install macOS on this board. I will make a separate video for it. Okay, now I am inside the Lattepanda computer. I am recording this screen using a screen recorder. And this is really a powerful SBC computer, guys. See how fast it is. Opening up the browser. Opens like a folder, guys. Here is the Play Store. Incredibly fast. Now, guys, let me arrange it a little bit. Now, I am going to test the performance of this Lattepanda board. First of all, I am going to connect my home Wi-Fi. Let's see those antennas are working or not. Now here I am connected to the internet. Now let's see some inner specifications. Here is my system properties. Windows 10 Pro, manufactured by Lattepanda. Intel Core M3 processor and 8GB RAM. Let me show you more in DXDiag. Here it is, language English, and it's compatible with DirectX 12. Here is the Intel HD graphics properties, 4GB total memory and 128MB display memory. Here is the Microsoft HD audio properties. Here is the sound too, and this is the input devices connected with the Lattepanda Alpha. The first thing I am very excited to test is 4K video support. It's really support the 4K video. Let's check it out. Searching a 4K video on Google, and here I found a 4K video on YouTube. Let's play it. And here we are running the 4K video on this tiny SBC board. Wow, really very more powerful than all other single board computers over there. Let me add little bit zoom here. So it's running at 1440p at the rate of 60Hz. Let's set up it to 2160p at the rate 60 frames. Now it's still running, guys. You can see full 4K video in this Lattepanda board. Let's watch it in a full screen. So that was the 4K test of this device, and which is very impressive. I really like it. Now guys, I am going to test the NVMe 64GB storage inbuilt in this board. Let's see how fast it is. Here I am starting the Crystal Disk Mark software. So the test is over, and here is the final results. The read-write speed of the inbuilt memory. Now I'm going to test the Heaven benchmark and the Superposition benchmark on this device. Let's start with the Heaven benchmark. With the 1080p settings, I am getting 8 to 10 frames per second. It slightly heavy for the Intel HD graphics. But in the 720p resolution, here I am getting 20 to 25 frames. This is nice to play games in average medium settings. For the single board computer, this is very enough, guys. And here you can see the frame is hitting over 30 frames per second. Now I am going to test it on superposition. Oh, it's superposition, guys. Going to test it with the 720 resolution, and here I am getting 10 to 15 frames. I don't know how this frame works and how you identify which frame is best for the game. I just believe to play games directly without testing any frames. So guys, now I am going to install the PUBG Mobile, the emulator version, on this Lattepanda Alpha computer. Let's see how this game performs with the Intel HD graphics. The game is almost installed, guys, and here it is. It opened very fastly, guys. I forgot to record. Now let me log into my account so I can show you the performance of this game in this Lattepanda Alpha board. So the game is started. Let me remove those ads. And here you can see the game is running very perfectly. I am moving my character. It's moving fast. And I am now going to play the game in medium settings. I am not trying the ultra and the extreme setting right now because I don't have connected any external graphic card for this device. Leave this topic for the next video, guys. Now I'm going to play this game, and I am playing the game with the wireless keyboard, guys. Here it is. Some guys commented on my old eGPU video that it's fake because I'm not touching the keyboard. Rather than playing on laptop keyboard, I always like to play with a wireless keyboard and mouse. So the game is loaded, guys, and you can see here is not any lag. I'm running here and there. Now in the plane, you can see there is not any type of lag issues. The game is running smoothly in medium settings. Here I jumped on the Lipo Vaca area, guys. Let me show you my short gameplay. Here I found some guns on the warehouse. Now I'm going to find some enemies. How smoothly the game is running in this single board computer, guys. Let me show you in the full screen, guys. Playing PUBG in a full screen helps to identify the enemy from the far range. Here I am seeing a boat running on the road. Now I'm going to kill him. And what the hell? It was a trap. I am dead. He must be a Novo Master. Thor, where are you? Novo Master just killed me. The freaking Novo Master. Let's play the another game. And what is this? My name on the plane. You are seeing, guys? I am the top player. Now here is the short gameplay, guys. You can see how fast the game is running without any issue. Sorry for the sound, I have not connected any speakers to the board. So that was the PUBG Mobile emulator version gameplay. Next, I tried to install the Fortnite, but unfortunately I failed, because now Fortnite takes over 40 gigabytes to install on a hard drive, but currently I have only 35 GB available. But don't worry, guys, I will soon arrange a M2 SSD to install this game, and I will show you in my next video. So those were the basic tests of this single board Windows 10 computer. Tell me in the comments which section is more interesting for you and what new projects I will bring you in the next video. So that was my review on Lattepanda Alpha, the most powerful Windows 10 single board computer. Hope you like this video. If you really like, hit that like button and subscribe my channel with the bell icon for more video updates like this. And if you think my video is interesting, share this video with your friends and families. And if you want to buy this product, check out the link in the video description. So thanks a lot for watching, guys. See you in my next video.